Kenya,
when I came from Kenya,
naje maze kugira ibibazo bikomeye n'Imana.
I came when I had great problems with God.
Nabishaka.
I didn't want it.
Uko,
because
numvaga hari ibindi bintu yabaga ikora.
I would feel that there were other things God should have done.
Muri Makendaz.
In short, I came.
Hazu mugabo w'impumyi.
There came a man who was blind.
I'm sure
some of you remember him. You remember him. That blind man came because I had asked God. I wanted to go to Australia to study, to be a pilot. God said, come to Rwanda. And I will begin your ministry in Rwanda. I came, but after 8 months of refusing. I wanted to go like Jonah. I went to look for somebody who loved me a lot. I went to ask for money for a ticket from him so that I can run away and go to Australia. It was on Thursday. He told me, come on Monday to my office. On Saturday, I felt that I should pass through his house so that I greet them, and then when he sees me, he will remember on Monday we have an appointment. Because the rich usually forget a lot. When I got there on Saturday, I knocked. There was nobody to receive me. Besides that house, the neighbor came, asked me, who do you want? I said, I want the owner of this house. He asked me, don't you know the news? He told me,
they
went to Mombasa for a weekend, and then they had an accident, a terrible accident. The children and the wife are okay, but the man is in a coma. I asked, can't he talk? Because I was feeling he should be able to tell the wife to sign a check for me. I came to understand something. When you give value to your problem, you become selfish. Somebody is in the coma, I can't feel that pain. I am only pained by the fact that he can't sign a check for me. I continued, and when I went ahead, I felt something hit my head like thunder. I had a voice. You know the reason why he has gone into a coma. You want to run away. The calling of God. Because I love people, I felt God, forgive me, heal him, I'm going to Rwanda. But I ask you, things that you have told me are too much. Bring me somebody else who doesn't know these things to tell me. After that, I will go. I heard the voice again. Now that you have accepted to go, that man will be in a coma for 12 days, but he will come out whole. And I'm going to send you somebody who is going to give you this information. Wait for him for 2 weeks. In my head, I did not understand that 2 weeks is 14 days. 2 weeks when they were over, I saw a man who was blind who had come from. He had walked for 2 weeks so that he could get to Nairobi.
Yari afite umwana umurandata.
He had a child that
yaciye zabunagana cya Uganda agenda n'amaguru arara ahantu kugeza ageze I Nairobi.
He came on foot from Congo all the way through Uganda until he came to Nairobi.
Ninjye yari aje gushaka.
I'm the one he came to look for.
Arambwira ngo,
he told me,
ngiye kumureba aho yarari.
When I went to look at him where he was, he asked me a question in Kiswahili.
Kwa nini unamsumbua Mungu?
Kuverichi uri kunanizima ano.
Avudyo jambo,
when he said that word,
numva rigeza hano.
It touched someone.
Nibaza uwo ndiwe.
I asked, who am I?
Nibaza no kubuza Imana amahoro icyo cyo.
And I asked myself, why am I not giving God?
Ndavuga ngo no mbabarira ndage.
I said, forgive me, I am going.
Arambwira ngo ufite iminsi 10.
He told me you have 10 days
muri iki gihe
in this nation.
Nirangira,
if it is over,
bizakubaho ntumbaze.
What will happen to you, don't ask me.
Nta tike nari mfite.
I did not have ticket.
Nta muntu nari nzi.
I did not know anybody.
Ntege ndasenze Imana mbitike ndagiye.
I pray to God to give me the ticket to go.
Ndayibuze.
I didn't get it.
Ku munsi wa 9,
on the 9th day,
ndaransenga Imana mbitike.
I prayed the whole night.
Ndayibuze.
I did not get the ticket.
Fungu tunu twanje.
I put all my things together.
Bisi bita Akamba yajaga Uganda.
I went to a bus called Akamba that used to go to Uganda.
Kamfe kujayo numunsi wa 10 Imana itanyiki bone ko nagiye.
I said, let me go on this 10th day so that God will see that I went and he will not kill me.
Ariko na faranga nari mfite.
But I did not have money.
Ndagiye ku murongo wo muntu watangaga warigurishaga matike.
I've gone to the line behind the person that is giving the ticket.
Ndavuga ngo nimugera.
I said, by the time I get there, I will give him my entire problem and see if he can give me a ticket of
grace. Three
people ahead of me so that I get
there.
Somebody gave him money.
He
insulted him. This man had a lot of wrath. And I said, he's insulting people with money. I don't have.
Ndabivamonde.
How do I come out of this?
Subi inyuma ku murongo.
I went to the end of the line.
Ibyo nabigize inshure eshatu.
I did that 3 times.
Kibaza mu buzima ngiye gusaba kandi ngiye gusaba utanyumva.
And I'm saying I am going to ask to beg, and the person I'm begging.
Hasigaye babiri kandi.
When 2 people were there,
ndavuga man.
I said, God.
Njyewe ni ntabona tike ukanyica niwe uzaba ukoza amakosa kuko nge nemeye kugenda ariko nabuze tike.
If you don't give me a ticket and then you kill me, the mistake will be yours because I have accepted to go. And this man is really bad. He's really abusing people. In short, I saw a lady. She had a handbag. She came.
How are you, Paul?
She asked me, how are you, Paul?
Paul,
where are you going?
I
said, I'm going to Uganda, but I'll also get to Rwanda. Then she gave me 2,000 Kenya shillings.
Nyafashe.
When I got it,
mumutwe numva igihumbi kimwe kizangeza Kenya ikindi kizangeza Rwanda. Kandi niko byari bimeze. Ako kanya ndimo mbitekereza ngiye kuvuga ngo urakoze ndamubura.
That time when I received it, I felt in me, 1,000 will get me to Kampala, another to Kigali. And when I opened my eyes to tell her thank you, she had gone. And from where I was to the exit door was far. So I said she couldn't have gone there. So I thought she must have gone to the toilet. So I decided to go and wait at the toilet door so that when she comes out, I will tell her thank you.
Ubwo
that time, I waited for her 10 minutes. I started entering into ladies' toilets opening. I did not see her.
I
said, where has this person gone? I forgot about it.
Fata bus.
I took the bus.
Gihumbi kimwe koko.
1,000.
Ikindi.
The other.
Nagifat ni bus naifati Kampala.
I will get it in Kampala.
Sinari ifite amafaranga ya hoteli.
I did not have hotel money.
Naraye muri gari.
I stayed the night in
Umugabo twari kumwe.
The man we were together.
Nguriya hariya. Haguruka papa, haguruka.
That's the man we were together.
I Kampala.
In Kampala.
Urabyibuka neza.
You remember it very well.
Arabyibuka neza.
He remembers it.
Ko namubwiye amakuru yanjye yose.
Because I told him my entire story.
Ni nawe wanyerekaga Rwanda.
He's the one who showed me Rwanda.
Twinjiranye nawe mu modoka.
We came together in the same.
None azambwiye amakuru.
He came telling me the stories.
Amakuru ya RPF.
Of RPF.
Aranganiriza numva gizeyite. Kuko sinumvaga ibintu numva mu mutwe ngizeyite.
Now I had an idea because I couldn't understand these things. He told me today, this is the day that they started the war. I felt like Abraham when he was going to Canaan. When we go to Kagitumba, he told me this is Rwanda. That man. We came sitting
together,
talking all the way from Kampala to get to here. Yesterday, I put my eyes back. I never came out of my room. I left my room at five. Asking myself, have I really fulfilled the mission that God gave me? 16 years that are gone. I remember. 16 years in the Bible,
Abisrael,
the children of Israel, they had stopped building the temple.
Igihe cha Haggai,
the time of Haggai,
barongere barahagu.
They began to build it again.
None undivas.
And then I asked myself,
ibi nubzose bitagenze mu buzima bwanje nibi.
The things that have not gone well in my life, what are they?
Ngenda ndeba.
I went looking.
Esibye Imana yansabye gukora ntakoze nibi.
The things that God asked me to do, what have I done? What I have done and I have done bad, what are they? I made a decision never again to waste time. 16 years. Today, if God takes me, the thing that brought me to Rwanda, what would I tell God before him and tell him I have done? Those are the things I was looking
for.
I did an auto evaluation. And I looked at myself afresh. My life. My environment. My family. Those we work with. The church. The ministry we are in. The nation. All those things. I looked at them. To the extent now. I think that by the power of God, by the grace of God, I am going to increase my harvest. By the power of God. And I ask all my colleagues that we are together, so that we change our mindset and the way we work. And the whole church. I want us to put the things of the past far away and we begin new things. We have a church that looks like it's new. You can see we have rebuilt
it.
But I want even our hearts inside to be rebuilt. Let our hearts become new. The times of wasting of time are no longer there. All our ambitions are dead because of this calling.
No joke.
There's no joke. What is not fruitful, we remove it, we run away from it, we do what is fruitful, so that tomorrow God will not ask us. Then you are not asked by God. I heard the voice of God hit like thunder in Nairobi. God is terrible. God, don't joke with him. We know it. We know it where he called us. We It is beginning to revive our life.
Bavandi.
Brethren, pray for the leadership of Zion Temple so that they can stand and do what God wants to do all over in the world. Here, in Europe, in America, everywhere we have leadership of Zion Temple. God to continue to reveal himself to us like he revealed himself to us. God revealed himself to Moses 3 times. The first time is at the burning bush. He did not stay long with God. After 40 years, when he's coming from Pharaoh, God manifested himself. When he got to the wilderness, God stayed with him. And he's manifested himself to him 40 days. Then they had a third appointment for 40 days. I want in the cycles of our life, every cycle, let God reveal himself to us. After that, we will show the people of God the land of promise. This Rwanda is a land of promise. This Rwanda is a nation that people don't know. This is a country that God is jealous about more than any other nation. You people who are inside, you have special grace. I ask you, do not take this grace for granted like the children of Israel. The children of Israel chased away God and God went. But let God be God. Let put God in the high place. Let him be God in the low place. Let him be God in the marketplace. Let him be God in the church. Let it be him be God in our life. That is what I desire. God bless you.
Numvagane burekere aho tugasenga tugataha ariko kwari umugenzo reka mbasomere ibintu nka bitatu gusa numugenzo reka dukore uyu mugenzo.
I thought I could do that and then we go home, but because of tradition, let me read 2-3 things for you.
Sinzi ko hari ubundi butumwa umuntu yaba afite buruto.
I don't know if there is any other message that is greater than that.
Gendure visa ubuzima bwa.
You go and revisit your life.
Kora vidaje y'ubuzima bwa.
Go and make a total overhaul of your life. Stop joking with God and the children of God. Stop joking with the church of God. Stop joking with your family. Go and do a revision of your life. God showed me things. I shouted, I said, this is impossible. God told me it is true. I have a lot of pain in me. I was startled. I asked God, give me an evaluation. Show me the heart of this church, the heart of our pastors, the heart of everybody. I ask you, go and make your things clean. Paul said, Father God, I'm not going to be tired for nothing. It's not possible for the nights that we spend. And then when God comes to quote you, he quotes you badly. Praying, reading, doing all this, doing research. Then when God comes to measure you, you find you have done nothing. Yesterday I had a visit of God like the one I had with him in Nairobi. I'm not lying to you.
mitima yacu meze nk'urupapuro rusomwa.
Our hearts are like a paper that can be read.
Imana yampaye gusoma mitima yabe.
God gave me to read the hearts of many.
Nasomye mitima myinshi. Urwandiko.
I read many hearts like a letter.
Pereye kuwanje.
Beginning with mine.
Nasobanuke kumunda tigizi.
And then I realized that somebody, nobody knows himself. God showed me things and I said, God, this is not me. He told me, that is you. 16 years. 10 years. Zion having started. We started with you. Show us your spiritual harvest. The word we read says Jesus in the house. Jesus was in the house. What was going to happen? The first thing that happens, cleaning up. Because he's a visitor greater than all other visitors. When you go to receive a great person, you make that place clean. But Jesus, we make him sit in a defiled place. That's why Jesus doesn't have enough power in our lives. Jesus looks like he's weak, yet he's a strong Jesus. We have a strong Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus
who is in us is strong.
Jesus
who is in us is able.
Power. After power.
He has power.
Yesu turimo afite imbaraga nyinshi cyane.
Jesus in us has a lot of power.
Ariko agaragara gakeya.
But he manifests very rarely.
Imbaraga ze zigaragara gake.
When does his power manifest?
Mu gitabo cya Marko ibice bibiri.
In the book of Mark chapter 2.
Ku murongo wa mbere kugeza kuwa 12.
From first verse to 12th verse.
Inkurira hano kwivuga.
This is the story.
Ngo Yesu asubira Kapernaum yinjira mu nzu.
Went back to Capernaum and went into a house. The Bible says many people came into that house. Jesus started preaching the word. There were four men that
came.
They were carrying a bed. And on that bed was somebody who was lame, who was not able to walk. They came and when they got to the door, the Bible says they were not able to come in because the doors were closed. People were many, inside and outside. Outside. All these people were not discouraged. They went on top of the house. They removed some tiles. They brought the man down. The Bible says they brought him where Jesus was. When Jesus saw him, he told him, your sins are forgiven. In that house, there were scribes seated there. Scribes. Then they started wondering in their hearts, this man, why is he proud of himself? That I have forgiven sins. He's only God who forgives sins. Who is this man? Jesus knew what was in their heart. He said, why are you wondering in yourself? Saying that, can this one forgive? What is easy? To tell this man, rise up and take your bed and walk, or to tell him your sins are forgiven. That moment, Jesus told the paralytic, I command you, rise up. Take your bed and go. That moment, he rose up. He took his bed. He went out. He went out in the presence of the people. When all the people saw it, they said, What this kind of thing? This kind of thing. We have never seen them.
Yes, akiri mu nzu.
When Jesus was in the house.
Yes, acicaranye nabo.
When Jesus was sitting
yababwiye ijambo.
He told them a word.
Ntibabonye imbaragaza.
They did not see the
power. Ariko bamaze gusenya igisenge cy'inzu.
When they had broken the roof of the house.
Nicyo gihe babonye Yesu.
That is the time they saw the power.
Hari ibisenge icyenda.
There are 9 roofs.
Bituma Yesu ukuri mu atagaragara.
That make Jesus in you not manifest.
Ibyo bisenge ko ari icyenda.
Those 9 roofs.
Bitumye Yesu turimo.
They make Jesus in us.
Ataboneka.
Not to be manifested.
Igisenge cy'ambere twakivuzeho.
The first one we talked about it.
N'abantu.
It's people.
Abantu.
People.
Yaraje.
He came.
Asanze wa mubembe. Asanze abantu ari benshi.
When this lame person found that there were many people.
N'abamuhetse.
And the ones that were carrying him.
Birashoboka ko.
It was possible.
Bavuze ngo.
They said.
None se ko bafite amaguru bananiwe kwinjira twe duhetse n'ikirema turinjira.
Now that those who have legs are unable to enter, we who are carrying a lame person, how can we enter?
Impression abantu baguha.
The impression people give you.
Tuzayemere.
Do not accept.
Uzafate impression yima.
Get the impression of God.
Igisenge cy'ambere.
The first roof.
Ni impression y'abantu.
Is the impression of people.
Iyo wabashije kugikuraho.
When you are able to remove.
Ibyo abantu bibwira.
What people say.
Umanuka.
You go down to Jesus. The Jesus of weakness becomes a strong.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Twabivuze.
We said about
that.
The second one.
N'ukwisuzugura complex d'inferiority.
The roof of inferiority complex.
Uyu muntu.
This person.
Yasaga na hari umu second citizen cyangwa se umuntu wa kabiri mu bandi.
Used to look like he's a second class citizen.
Hari imitekerezo umuntu abazi.
There are some things that you know.
Ukumva ko barya ibyiza gusa ari bariya wewe warya ubuvungukira bwawe. Wewe wakwambara imyenda bashajishije. Wakwambara inkweto ba. Iyo ni ukuba ni inferior, ni complex d'inferiority. Ituma Yesu kuri mwatagaragara. Menya ko ibyo bariya bagezeho hamwe n'Imana nawe wabigeraho.
There is an inferiority complex that you can get, which tells you that you are a second-class citizen. You can only eat what others have remained. You can only wear what others have worn and thrown away. No, what they have reached and what they have done, you too can do it. Because in this world, every person has equal chances. The day Jesus brought us in the world, he gave us gifts like he gave others. But some people can make you not get there. The second one. You also feeling where they have placed you. That complex may make you not reach your destiny. Remove that roof from Jesus and he will do a miracle. Remove it from Jesus. And he will do a miracle. The third roof is laws.
Amategeko.
The laws.
Itegeko ryo gusenya n'itegeko ryo kubaka rirahaba.
The law of building and the law of destroying is there.
Tushobora kubaka.
You cannot build.
Udafite uburenganzira.
If you don't have the right.
Tushobora gusenya.
You cannot demolish.
Udafite ubundi.
If you do not have the right.
Hari itegeko.
There is a law.
Bageze hari.
When they got there.
Baratekereza.
They thought.
Tubigenze gute.
How do we do this?
Reka twurire hejuru y'inzu.
Let us go on top of this house.
Dukureho amategura.
And remove the tiles.
Hanyuma tumumanurire.
And then we bring him down.
Ariko se.
But then.
Tubifitiye uburenganzira.
Do we have a right to do that?
Hari igihe biba ngombwa.
There is a time it is important.
Kubw'inyungu z'ubwami.
For the kingdom interest.
Kubw'inyungu zo gukira k'umuntu.
For the interest of the healing of somebody.
Umuntu yirengagiza itegeko.
That you ignore a law.
Sindi umuntu wirengagiza amategeko.
I don't ignore laws.
Ariko hari igihe.
But there is a time.
Biba ngombwa.
It's important.
Ukuriraho Imana amategeko.
To remove the laws.
Ukuriraho Imana igisenge cy'amategeko.
To remove from the laws from God.
Esther.
Esther.
Yabwiye Mordecai.
He told Mordecai.
Ngo genda usenge.
You go and pray.
Ngo ndirengagize itegeko.
And then I am going to ignore and break the law.
Ngimbere y'umwami.
I'll go before the king.
Kugira ngo nkize bene wacu genocide
igiye kubaba. So that I heal our people.
Miriam yirengagije itegeko.
Broke the law.
Yari yarashizwe ahantu kureba gusa gaseke karimo Musa.
He had been put far to look at the basket where Moses
ariko
was.
Abonye bamufashe.
But when she saw
yirengagije itegeko aravuga ngo mumpe uwo mwana mbashakira umurezi.
She broke the law and said, "Let me look for a maid for that child."
Ibari bibagiye ko nyiri gisenga ari bushwane.
She had not forgotten that the owner of this child, they are going to have problems.
No.
They had not forgotten the owner of the roof. They are going to have a problem with them because there are laws. But in this hour, there are no laws. When you go to help somebody, you don't ask for laws. When your neighbor beats the wife, you don't wait for the laws. There are some things that makes Jesus not to manifest. There are laws that we put against him. Jesus, I'm going. When I get there, they will not know me. Even you keep quiet. There are some places where we allow Jesus to speak in us, others we tell him to keep quiet. The way you will hold Jesus, that's the way he will be. If you take him as a coward, he will be a coward. If you take him as a strong man, he will be a strong man. Remove that roof of laws. The fourth one is the roof of rituals. Rituals. There are traditions that people are used to. There are programs that people have placed for themselves. And they make Jesus not able to come and
minister.
And even when he comes in there, he's like a matchstick in a matchbox. The matchstick lights when you strike it on the
matchbook.
When you remove that roof and Jesus comes out, he will do that miracle. To bring that person in the house, it was going to break the order of the protocol. Because all of them were going to start looking at the lame man instead of looking at Christ. They knew that they are going to bring disorder. They knew that they are going to break the order. They knew that Jesus would stop teaching. But it was important. It was not easy, but it was important.
Hallelujah!
Praise God. They brought him. They ignored the laws. They ignored the order of the church. If you want Jesus to work for you, there are some things that you need to ignore. Break those rituals that you have put on yourself. You are afraid of putting music, Christian music, in your car. Yes. Because you don't want people to know that you are saved. You want people to feel like you are ordinary. You only want Christ to manifest on Sunday when you come to church. But when you are at work, you don't want him to be manifested, people to know. How comes Muslims put on their cap, they come to work? How comes when it is time for them to pray, they go and pray? They don't fear to be known. You who has Jesus, you want to hide him. Why?
Wangira speaker ivugira kwisi yose ngo mbwire abantu bareke yesagaraga.
If only they would make me a speaker to speak to the whole world and tell them, allow Jesus to manifest in you.
Yes, twaramufungira.
Jesus, we have really bound him in our pockets, in our rooms. Let us remove Jesus from the rooms where we have locked him. And when we go out as ordinary people. Jesus is in the house. He needs to manifest. We must remove that roof of rituals. The fifth one is the roof of materialism.
Material.
Things, material things. If this man had asked Jesus for the owner of the house for permission to break, he probably would have started thinking about the losses and the gains. And then he would have told them, you be quiet for some time, let's negotiate. Or don't touch my house. My house, I built it. I broke
about it.
You touch my roof, you will have touched my heart. The time has come. When we sacrifice things for the interest of God. When you have not sacrificed the material things that you have, the things that you love in your heart, your Jesus will not manifest. The time for us to remove that, to give as a sacrifice, the roof has come. You need to sacrifice that roof. And then Jesus will manifest. Those things that have
hold,
those things that you have, the things that you say, I broke for them. When you see that car, I really want that for it. When you see this house, I really
want it.
Those things have a greater time for you than Jesus in you. They are the ones that have made the roof of riches has made many people not to see Jesus manifest in them. Let go of those things. Let them go out of your heart. Wash your heart. Remove that roof. Say, Jesus, you are my riches.
Yes.
Jesus,
you
are my things.
Yes,
Jesus will do it.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If
you have accepted to sacrifice, they accepted for the healing of this person. You must sacrifice much so that Jesus can do a miracle for you. There are people who love their beds. The time has come for you to sacrifice your bed, sleep on the floor. You have slept on it, nothing changed. Change the position, sleep on the ground, and things will change.
Hey.
Yes. Even those who don't have money in their bank accounts are there. There's a time God takes all of it so that you can sacrifice the materialism in you. The sixth roof, the roof of symptoms, external symptoms. These people came and told Jesus, heal this man's lameness. When they were bringing him down, Jesus never prayed for the lameness. He said, your sins are forgiven. Why? There are sins that make you lame. Jesus was fighting with the root, but people were fighting with symptoms. The problem is not joblessness. The problem is the spirit of poverty. The problem is not the poverty you have. It's the spirit of losing that you have. The time has come when Jesus deals with the things inside. They brought him somebody. All of them had an impression that he's lame outside. People have all accepted that that is the problem he has. That's a symptom.
Yesu si kwa kora.
That's not the way Jesus works.
Imbere.
He works inside. The Bible says,
yes,
Jesus, he said, your sins are forgiven.
Amaze kurangiza ibyimbere.
When he finished what was inside,
atakarere ibyinyuma.
Then he attacked the things externally. He said, now take your bed. Inside of you, when it is all right, the things of outwardly will also be okay. Pray for me. My husband doesn't love me. Those are symptoms. It's not a problem of not being loved. There's a problem that Jesus knows. Because he used to love you.
Nanubu hari udukorwa tumwakore yataguwe n'abakagukorera neza. Urukundo rurahari ariko ikibazo kiriya imbere.
Even today there are some things he does to you that he wouldn't have done. The problem is not there. The problem is deep somewhere.
Mureke tureke Yesu.
Let's allow Jesus
arebe biri imbere.
To look at what is inside.
Nitumurimite. Oh Yesu ya wowe wivuga ngo urababarira ibya hagurutse kirema gusa se tu.
Let's not limit Jesus to only raising the limb. Let's also tell him to forgive the sins.
Haru mudamu.
There's a lady.
Ikisangani.
In Kisangani.
Yagize ikibazo aravunika.
She had a problem and she broke
Achika
her leg.
Igufwa ry'umurundi.
Her femur was broken.
Ntabwo yarakishijwe.
She was not saved.
Ariko antumaho.
Then she sent for me.
Ngonje kumusengera.
To go and pray for her.
Tujana na Pastor Charles.
We went with Pastor Charles that time.
Amusengera.
We prayed for her.
Tumaze gusenga.
After we prayed, that moment, the bone came back. They put her through the x-ray. It looked like it had never ever broken. She went home. When she got home, she called all her friends. And she prepared a bar. She made a big all the wines and spirits and the alcohol that was there, she brought it. That day, I heard in my spirit, go and visit that mama. I called Charles to go and look for that woman. We went there. When we got there by the door, she called me. It was a
Paul,
what are you going to drink? Score?
Yes.
She was drunk.
Eh?
Yes.
Nakai, eh? Primus, it don't score.
Primus or the small skull?
Eh? Mama.
I said, Mama.
You
know I don't drink.
Oh, yeah.
Oh no.
Akira.
You take.
Akayeri.
You take.
Ashaka kukan namik.
He wanted to give it to me. I told her, thank you, I just came to see whether you are okay. We went out. When we were on the way, I told Pastor Charles, I heard a voice. It has told me, she's going to have a problem that is greater than the first one. And she escorted us. She went back. When she got there, she slid. The other leg that was broken, it was broken. We went back to pray for her. It was not possible. She died while crippled. She came back to Rwanda on crutches. What we were able to do, we caused on the symptoms. The things that are manifested. But the things of inside we never Jesus was going to heal the way people wanted. But Jesus, when the roof is removed, he does more than what people want. People had brought him to be healed of his lameness. But the problem was not lameness, the problem was sin.
Amen.
Amen.
Iyo Yesu aza kumusengera.
When Jesus came to
pray, akamuhagurutse
and rose him up.
Urya bayarakize.
He would have been healed.
Ariko nyuma y'icyumweru.
But after a week.
Nyuma y'ukwezi.
After a month.
Nyuma y'umwaka.
After a year.
Aba yarongeye kumuga.
He would have gone back there.
Icyate y'ubumuga bwe.
The reason for the lameness
cyari cyahakimuri.
Was the sin in him.
Yesu akuyemo umuzi.
When Jesus removed that root.
Amaze gukuramo icyo kintu kimbere.
When Jesus removed that inward thing.
Ibyinyuma byarikemuye.
The things of the outward soul themselves. Then he rose up.
Ogende. Imana igufashe.
May God help you.
Ukuremo ibyimbere.
To remove the things.
Icyakarindwi ni imyigishirize.
The seventh one is the roof of doctrine.
Imyigishirize.
Doctrine.
Aba banditsi.
These scribes.
Bari bafite uko bumva ibintu.
They had a way of understanding things.
Haruba barira hari nukiza.
There's one who forgives, there's one who heals.
Yego Yesu arakiza.
Yes, Jesus heals.
Ona ababarira ibyo ni iby'Imana.
But he does not forgive. That belongs to
Harabafite doctrine na n'uyu munsi.
There are people up to today who have doctrines.
Ibabwira ko igihe cyo gukiza n'ibitangaza cyarangiye.
That tell them that the days of miracles and healing are gone.
Iyo ugerera ugahura n'ababivuga wumva ari abasazi.
When you get to them, You get to people who say that Jesus heals, you think they are mad.
Imyigishirize mibi umuntu aba yarabonye imubera ikibazo gituma Yesu murimo ataba umunyembara.
The false doctrines you received make Jesus in you not to become strong. I ask you today, you just have a doctrine of Jesus. Say, Jesus, I believe you are able. All things you are able, you do miracles. Where we were, where we grew up, the schools we grew up in, the religions we were in, all of those put a roof on us that make Jesus not to manifest. Let us destroy it today in the name of Jesus. Begin. Let Jesus become your mind.
Yes, abidini ryawe.
Let Jesus become your religion.
Yes,
let Jesus become your spirit.
Abanditsi.
They were amazed.
Ariko Yesu arababwira.
But Jesus told them,
ngo nahawe ubutware bwo kubabara ibyaha by'abantu.
I was given the authority to forgive the sins of men.
Igisenge cy'umunani.
The eighth roof.
Ni igisenge cy'imitekerereze.
The roof of mindset.
Imitekerereze.
Mindset.
There
is a way people hear things and they say, that's the way I understand things. Don't tell me anything else. Don't make me tired. I have made my decision. People are made by their mindsets. Our thoughts are what
own us.
Those thoughts reach a point where they turn to become ours. They guide the way we think, the way we go, the way we do things. Listen, brethren. Mindset may have stopped this man from being healed because he had been condemned to be on the bed all the days of his life. But he never accepted. He never accepted. When you have a certain mindset, you have no hope. You have no hope in you. But Jesus told him a powerful word that touched his mindset. He said, I command you, rise up. Our mindset needs somebody who will command it. Sometimes you think that people are dictators. It's not that they are dictators. They are working on mindset that have refused to change. There are times when it is necessary for somebody to command you, go home early, come back early. He's trying to straighten you up. There are times somebody will have to come and command you what to eat because you are used to eating too much. You eat everything you find, you drink everything you find, you sleep when you want. But there are times somebody needs to come so that he can take care of your health and command you, eat this, eat little, sleep this time.
There are times.
There's some children who don't know how to come home early. They go to every wedding, they go to every morning place. Everywhere there is food, they are out there, they come late. You need to give them a new mindset by tying their legs on the bed. If they stay there on that bed for 1 week, their mindset changes. Those who love going round and round, you need a rope.
So mindset so that your
mindset changes. Sometimes prison is not bad. It makes you think twice. Prison is good. Because there are people who get saved there. Prisons are good. People say, if I go back to the land of people, I will change. Anything that would make your mindset become changed and become good, it is good. Let's go there. This man heard that it is possible to stand up. After so many years, he could not stand up.
Kuraho.
Remove.
Icho gisenge ki. Gituma utekereza bitari byo utangira ugira imitekerezo mizima urebe uko Yesu yigaragaza mu buzima bwa.
Remove that roof that makes you have bad thoughts and you see if Jesus is not going to manifest.
Icyanyuma ari cyakena ricyo ndangirije.
The last one, the ninth one, this is where
ni gisenge cy'icyerekezo.
The roof of direction.
Yamanukiye hejuru mu gisenge ariko asohokera imbere y'abantu.
He came through the roof but he went out in the midst of people.
Umva.
Listen.
Hari kindi cyerekezo Imana igiye.
There is a new direction God is going to give.
Ubundi,
normally,
uko bamuzanye niko akagombye gusubira.
The way they brought him is the way they should have taken him up.
Ariko wa muntu.
But that man.
Bibiliya iravuga ngo.
The Bible says.
Ngobzuka.
He woke up.
Wikoreye ngobzi.
Take your bed.
Urumva.
Listen.
Ingobzi yari mwikoreye.
The bed that used to carry him.
Ariko ibintu birahindutse.
Now things have changed.
Nawe yikoreye.
Now you take it.
Arabigerageza.
He tried it.
Yumva birakunze.
He says it's so possible.
Afata kamaterake agakubita hejuru.
He took his mattress and
hanyuma aradefile ngo asohokere imbere y'abantu.
He started coming out before people.
Ntiyasabye urwego ngo asubire hahandi hejuru.
He did not ask for a ladder to go back where.
Hari ibintu byinshi dukora.
There are many things we do.
Iyo tumaze guhabwa icyerekezo.
When we are given a direction.
Dukora ibikwiriye.
We do the right things.
Dukora ibikwiriye.
We do the right things.
Imana igiye kuguha icyerekezo.
God is going to give you a direction.
Niwikuraho icyerekezo kibi warufite.
When you remove that wrong direction you had.
Yes, arakubera icyerekezo.
Jesus is going to be your direction.
Arakwereka ubuzima bwawe.
He will show you your life.
Uyu mugabo.
This man.
Yari afite icyerekezo cy'urupfu.
He had a direction of death.
Yari kondane kuzapfa.
He was condemned to die on that.
Ariko uyu munsi Yesu amubwira ko ari icyerekezo cy'ubugingo.
But Jesus told him there is a direction of life.
Ashobora kugenda.
That he can go.
Ashobora kugenda.
That he can go.
Imbere y'abantu.
Before people.
Ikiza nabikundiye.
The thing I liked about this.
Nuko byenda.
Is that probably.
Mu bamusetse uwo munsi bari bahari.
The people who had laughed him that day were there.
Ah, kia kimugasa kizigeza kwiki.
That lame person, what does
he do? Uwo munsi nawo.
That day, he took his bed and his mattress and he passed through them when they were watching. And they shook their heads. We have not seen such things. People have not talked about you. Because they have not seen Jesus. But there is a morning. They will see you walking. They will see you riding
there,
carrying that mattress. Carrying the pain you had. That had been on
your body.
That sickness that was there for many years. And now you have victory in your
hand.
All of them will say. We have not seen things like this. When we let Jesus
out of it.
People will say things like this. We have not seen. Those are the things I wish for. Those who know you will know you in another way. All of them will say, we have never seen such things. An appointment on second
and God bless.
Let us rise up and pray. Amen.
Mana turagushima muri uyu mwanya.
God, we bless you this moment. Because you are opening doors for us. You are removing all the roofs that had surrounded us. In the name of Jesus. All these roofs that were on us. Remove them. Give us strength of removing them. And then you manifest. I pray for every person a blessing this week. Your peace. Your love. With the Holy Spirit, be with us. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Go with Jesus. May Jesus.